If you travel with more than one device, you know the routine. You get to where you're staying, you connect your phone, then your laptop, then your tablet, and then your wife connects her devices. And if you have kids, it's usually another round of tablets right after that. By the time everyone's online, you've basically done a full Wi-Fi setup and you're already playing tech support. That's why I've wanted something simple. This is the UniFi Travel Router, or UTR for short. It's a small, slim travel router that's meant to make your UniFi setup portable so you can bring your network with you wherever you go. It's super slim and super small, a lot smaller than it looks, about the size of a playing card, and it's about as thin as half a deck. It's powered by USB-C and has a small screen that gives you information about your connection and connected clients. It has spring-loaded gigabit Ethernet ports, one Uplink for LAN and one Uplink for WAN, and another USB port for USB tethering to your phone. Inside of the plastic body are two Wi-Fi 5 antennas that are used for connecting to Wi-Fi networks and broadcasting a network for the clients to connect to. So why would anyone want a travel router to begin with? Well, a travel router lets you connect to any internet connection, hotel Wi-Fi, Ethernet, or phone tethering once, and then everything behind it stays on your private network. It gives you a nice layer of isolation from public Wi-Fi, and the good ones make VPN connections really easy, letting you connect back to your home base as if you were physically there. I've been chasing the perfect travel router for a long time. I started with a basic router, a Cisco one for home that I carried with me. Then I built a full-on DIY travel setup that was basically a mobile home lab. And honestly, I loved it. It had maximum flexibility and it was a super fun learning project. But it was also more complicated than something you can just toss into a bag and trust to work every time. Then I moved to bringing a UniFi Express with me, which gets me most of what I want. However, it doesn't have a wireless uplink for public Wi-Fi networks and doesn't easily connect all of my devices back to my home. That's why I think this device is interesting, it's because it's aiming for grab and go. Setting up this thing is the best part because it's not one of those you need to be on site with a laptop situations. You can set it up even if you aren't on the network you need to connect to. Once you power it up, you'll see a QR code to install the UniFi Network mobile app, but if you already have the app, you just open it. You'll see the device appear in Site Manager, which makes sense because it doesn't belong to a site. It lets you connect to any site you want. Once you connect to it, the first real choice is, how do you want to WAN? I did what most people do when they travel, and I chose a Wi-Fi uplink. That's the public network that you want to connect your travel router to. After you're connected, you can bind it to a site you want to connect back to. After choosing your site, you pick one of the Wi-Fi networks you want the UTR to broadcast. I chose my home network. From there, it creates a teleport VPN connection, broadcasts my home Wi-Fi network, and all of my devices can now connect to it. Teleport is Ubiquiti's term for creating a WireGuard VPN connection without any configuration at all. You can share links with users, which work with the Wi-Fi Man app and will instantly connect them to your network. The UTR does this automatically, and the device even appears as a teleport user in your clients list. I was honestly impressed at how seamless this was. Once my devices saw my home network Wi-Fi, they automatically connected, and now everything was being tunneled through this device back to my home network. I tested the newly created Wi-Fi, and I was able to get around 100 to 200 megabits up and down, which seemed a little bit slower than you would expect. I was connected at 80 megahertz, which should give me around 800 megabits per second, but we have to take into consideration that there is only one radio in this device, so it's doing double duty, both working as a Wi-Fi uplink for WAN and creating a wireless network for all the devices to connect to. You can get much higher speeds by using the WAN Ethernet port, so that's what I decided to test next. There are two Ethernet ports, one LAN and one WAN, and they're spring-loaded, so they stay closed to keep the device really slim. If you want to plug something in, you just pop open the door and the port's right there. I connected the WAN port and reran my speed test. Now that the Wi-Fi wasn't doing double duty, connecting to a Wi-Fi uplink and connecting client devices, I was seeing anywhere from 300 to almost 400 megabits per second, so quite a big jump. Next, I connected the LAN connection to a laptop through a USB-C Ethernet adapter. I was getting around 500 to 600 megabits per second, and that's honestly pretty impressive considering it's creating a tunnel back to my home network and encrypting the traffic all from this tiny little device. Another feature this supports is USB WAN, where you can tether your phone to the travel router and share your connection. You do that by connecting your phone to the UTR's other USB-C port, and the router treats your phone like a WAN connection. When I tested it, I was getting about 50 megabits per second on a laptop connected to the Wi-Fi network. Now, that speed didn't have anything to do with the UTR. It was my cellular's download speed at the time. I confirmed this by running a speed test afterwards on just my phone. It's safe to say that USB tethering works fine, but without another carrier, I'm not really sure where this tops out since my mobile data was slow at the time. Now, the one thing I haven't been able to test today is captive portals. Ubiquiti says it works, but I won't be able to properly validate that until I'm actually traveling somewhere that has a captive portal. I'll test it out and I'll report back what I find. Since I was able to easily connect all of my devices securely back home with the Teleport VPN connection, I then wanted to see how far I could push the remote network. Another thing I travel with is a small Wyze cam that I use if I step out so I can check on the dogs. I wanted to see if I could replace the Wyze cam with a UniFi camera to make things a little more seamless when I travel. I connected a G6 Instant that was already adopted to Protect, and I was able to record footage back to my UNVR with the travel router. This means I don't need to bring my Wyze camera with me anymore, and I still get all of my AI detections too with the footage backed up remotely. Then I started to nerd out and I wondered what would happen if I tried to adopt a switch over the Teleport network. To my surprise, as soon as I plugged it into the LAN port of the UTR, it detected it and it allowed me to adopt the Flex Mini switch just as if I were at home. Now, this was more of an experiment than anything else, but it's good to know that it makes connecting other machines and expanding my remote network really easy if I want to bring like 10 machines with me. The biggest question I know people will have is, do you need a UniFi cloud gateway for this to make sense? Yes. The UTR itself isn't running a full UniFi OS console by itself. If you already have a UniFi cloud gateway at home, you're all set. If you don't, I don't think the UTR by itself is the right product for you. The whole point is binding this to a UniFi site using Teleport, which means you need a gateway running that site somewhere. And UniFi OS alone won't cut it. That too needs a gateway somewhere in your environment to terminate the Teleport connection. Long story short, if you're going to use this, you're going to need a UniFi cloud gateway. Overall, at $79, I think this is a really good value. It basically checks all of the boxes for me as a travel router, but there are a few small things that would make this even better. And to be clear, I'm nitpicking. Most of these are quality of life type fixes, and I know that any of these changes would probably push the price up. First would be a little bit more performance. Now, this device does everything that I need, and the speeds that I get are more than adequate to do the jobs that I need, but a little more headroom is always nice when you're tunneling and encrypting traffic. This might be solved with software updates, but there's only so much you could do with this little chip in here. On the app side, I'd love to see a better dashboard. Nothing too fancy, just quick at-a-glance info, like Uplink status, current traffic, number of clients, what site it's bound to, without having to dig through menus, something like you see on the UniFi cloud gateways. One thing that would have been nice to see in the box as well is a padded carrying case. This thing is just going to be chucked into a bag, so a simple neoprene protective case would have been perfect. Another thing I'd love to see is more firewall and router options. This is definitely a power user request, but it'd be really nice to have some firewall options like split tunneling, disabling MDNS and broadcasting, and other features you may not want to extend to this network. Disabling those sorts of things might make the network feel more responsive if you're connected via Teleport. And just some standard router options would be nice. There might be times when you don't want to teleport back into your network with a VPN connection, but you still want to provide a network for all of your devices like a standard travel router. And sure, I could ask for Wi-Fi 7, better radios, a battery, but now I'm really just designing a more expensive product. As it stands right now, I think the price feels pretty right, and it makes connecting devices to different UniFi sites ridiculously easy. I think it's easier than setting up the VPN client to my laptop. I just plug it in, a few taps later, I'm connected. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video on the UniFi travel router. I'm Tim. Thanks for watching.